Hello and welcome back to another episode of Skyrim Requiem 3Bf Tweaks. My name is Saiken and today we're continuing the Diaries of Death. This is still the story of Carlos de Silva, the Khajiit who is now firmly taken over the lead of the Thieves Guild, and is kind of an epilogue type of tier 1 episode. After this, given that I survive it, he would be in the pool of potential candidates that you can vote for a further adventure, kind of moving on to that tier 2 stage. And really what we want to do today is going into Thunderstone Gorge here, because I figured we do have a bit of a weight problem. I like our melee attack weapon, but the range attack weapon, the Nightingale bow with 12 weight, is quite heavy, and there is a hand placed spectral bow here that we also are using on our on Geoffrey Delors. If you haven't seen that, I think it is season 4, so here we go with a different build into this dungeon. A much more stealthy one this time. So we're going to do that, and afterwards we're handing in the skeleton key. Already started clearing the entrance, and yeah, let's go into Thunderstone Gorge. Now, in contrast to the previous build, this time we are much more sneaky and should be able to deal with many of these guys from the get-go. Yeah, our biggest weakness are undead still. Time to become invisible again. I can't move after I started attacking. Okay, so even with Maroon's Razor, we need to find still a better way of dealing with undeads. We don't have a great undead weapon. I found the location of Meridian's Beacon earlier, but I figured, wouldn't really fit the character. Now I'm almost reconsidering. We're not specialized in one-handed swords, but it would definitely solve our undead problem. So we do have 70 magic resist, which is plenty for what we're trying to do. She see us? Yeah, she sees us right away. Okay, we can't be taking hits like that. And the mages are officially awake. Still forced to stand there, kind of standing in place after the power attack. Decided to trade damage with him, but that's not a good way of doing it. I should be playing cleaner.
Ah!
Seven Firebolt's not bad, but I don't might as well take him. Should be playing cleaner is what I was about to say, because there's no need to take that damage. Need to find a good way of dealing with undeads. Not bad, definitely good. Okay, time for us to hopefully this time play a bit cleaner. One down. Two down. Assault is valuable. Okay, I can already hear the chanting. This should trigger a trap, shouldn't it? Nope, okay. Thanks to our skeleton key, even master chests are no longer safe. Ring of the Night, that's good. Fantastic loot, by the way. I'm almost sad that we need to give that skeleton key away. Summon. And that was a quick kill. Much quicker than normally. Oh wait. We still got Flame Atronach. Okay. So, here's our Spectral Bow. 5 weight, light bow, and also fantastic stats on it. Surpassing potion, even better. I feel we're getting quite a bit of good loot with this character. Brand Soul Gem. Lots of stuff that we can disenchant. Extreme Archery, yes please. Debilitation, yes please. Just in case we're going for enchantment later down the road. Even Ring of the Night with 90 additional armor is good. I like all of that, so we're going to keep it. We still keep the Nightingale Bow. It has a little bit more damage than the Spectral Bow. And it's good against against constructs. But for now we should be fine. I'm going to keep that Staff of Fireball. Good question. Could be an interim solution against the undead. We can recharge it, so that definitely would be an option. Which of the staffs? Okay, we'll keep that one. Good. Very good. Heal self, yes. Scroll of Fireball, I think unnecessary since we do have the staff now. That necklace is actually quite good. Hand place as well, 50% fire resistance. That'll be useful going forward. Cool. So, first dungeon done. Not the cleanest, and we still are facing challenges with undeads, but that might end soonish, as I am already having the Staff of Fireball. Next up, we unfortunately need to part ways with our skeleton key, but that'll happen in a second. Good, time for the second task. We are in the Twilight Sepulcher, right here. And it's time for the Path of the Pilgrim.
I don't recognize you, but I sense that you're the last of the Nightingale Sentinels, I'm afraid. I've defended the Sepulcher alone for what seems like an eternity.
What happened to the rest?
We were betrayed by one of our own kind. In fact, I'm to blame for what's happened here.
How are you to blame?
I was blinded. Blinded by dark treachery masquerading as friendship. Perhaps if I had been more vigilant, then Mercer Frey wouldn't have lured me to my fate and stolen the skeleton key.
Okay, wait a moment. You're Gallus?
I haven't heard that. How do you know of me?
Well, I do have the key, my friend.
The key? You have the skeleton key.
Mm-hmm.
I never thought I'd see it again. And Mercer Frey?
He's dead.
Then it's over, and my death wasn't in vain. I owe you a great deal, Nightingale.
I did this for
That's
an eternal.
That's quite a noble sentiment for someone in our... Well, in your line of work. My only regret is that you had to undertake this task alone.
Well, Kalia helped me, to be fair.
Kalia? She's still alive? I feared she'd befallen the same fate, ending up a victim of Mercer's betrayal.
Well, take the key and right all the wrongs.
Nothing would bring me more pride than to return the key, but I'm afraid it's impossible. From the moment I arrived here, I felt myself, well, dying.
How can a spirit die?
The sepulcher isn't merely a temple or a vault to house the key. Within these walls is the Evermere, a conduit to Nocturnal's realm of Everglow. When Mercer stole the key, that conduit closed, severely limiting our ties to her.
Then I'll have to proceed alone.
I'm afraid so. I'm weakening, and I can feel myself sleeping. Whatever damage has been caused can only be corrected by following the path.
Good. They're almost exclusively undeads here. Well, spirits, to be precise. So we're not sure how well we're going to do against them.
Does someone live?
Well, that wasn't the best fight ever. Could have been much cleaner. I think they heard me cast. Twelve ebony arrows of shock. Well, that ain't that quite a reward. Surpassing potions. Love it. Boots of extreme sneaking, that could be helpful as well. Regeneration potion. No, we did not. So that should take care of the low health. The memory serves me well. The light was the big problem here. That almost makes it worse. Take a look. Wall hack on, no enemy here. Quite a bit of loot, actually. Ebony sword is nice. The ebony ignis would be fantastic as well. Another ebony dagger. Okay, well, We don't need the individual coin. And the gold ignits can go as well. If I had a shout, that would be fantastic. I almost forgot just how trap-riddled this entire place was. Quite a lot of arrows and good loot. That was a skill book, one that we've already read. That is a very helpful skill book for us. Okay, let's proceed. Time to get into the sanctum itself. That is helpful. That is helpful, Ender's message. I can't believe it. I came all the way, so after all of the ridiculous riddles, just end up here after memorizing Nimmon's clues he'd collected from Lithelius. I slit his throat. Now I guess the joke's on me because I'm stuck here. I don't see any way out. I hope someone comes by soon. I am getting hungry. Thank you.
What do we have here?
It's been a number of years since I've set foot on your world. Or perhaps it's been moments. One tends to lose track. So, once again, the key has been stolen, and a champion returns it to the sepulcher. Now that the Evermere has been restored, you stand before me awaiting your accolades. A pat on your head, a kiss on your cheek. What you fail to realize is your actions were expected, and represent nothing more than the fulfillment of your agreement. Don't mistake my tone for displeasure. After all, you've obediently performed your duties to the letter. But we both know this has little to do with honor and oaths and loyalty. It's about the reward, the prize. Fear not. You'll have your trinkets, your desire for power, your hunger for wealth. I bid you to drink deeply from the Evermere mortal, for this is where the agent of Nocturnal is born. The oath has been struck, the die has been cast, and your fate awaits you in the Everglow. Farewell, see to it that you stay this time, won't you?
All right, Kalaya.
I'm glad you were able to bring the key back safely. Nocturnal seemed quite pleased with your efforts.
She sounded rather indifferent.
I wouldn't take that to heart. It's her way. Think of her as a scolding mother continually pushing you harder to be successful, outwardly sounding angry, but silently content. I assure you, had she been displeased with you, we wouldn't be having this conversation.
What's this about becoming an agent of Nocturnal?
The circles at the base of the Evermere imbue you with powers befitting a Nightingale agent. The crescent moon represents the agent of stealth, the half moon for the agent of subterfuge, and the full moon for the agent of strife.
Why can't it be all three?
This is Nocturnal's way of maintaining balance. If you ever feel the need to change your abilities, you can return to the Sepulchre and step onto a different circle. Be warned that once you've chosen, you can't reselect for at least a day.
So what now?
Now, your life as a Nightingale begins. Should the need arise, you'll be summoned to the Sepulchre in order to defend it.
And you?
The Guild has welcomed me back with open arms. I feel like a void in my life has finally been filled. I only hope that this isn't an ending to things, but actually the beginning.
The beginning of what?
Why, perhaps the greatest crime spree Skyrim's ever known. There are pockets brimming with coin and coffers overflowing with riches ripe for the picking. We may be Nightingales, but in our hearts we're still thieves, and we're damn good at what we do. Choose your path.
Very good.
Your journey will be complete.
So we got the full moon, striker, the half moon, and then
Carlisle.
The no moon whatsoever, which will give us a nice little bonus. Let me show you. So Nightingale agent. I thought that would work now. Let's double check. We should have gotten something. Seems to be wrong. Something definitely seems to be wrong. We should have gotten our bonus. And the reason why I chose stealth is because it gives you the ability to automatically, the moment that you're entering stealth, enter invisibility, which is fantastic. It would be an absolute game changer for us. Far superior than the skeleton key, which in itself is already quite good. But it seems that it did not immediately work, so I need to go back in and try to fix it. I think the reason why it hadn't worked is I have not yet done what I was supposed to do, which is actually drink. So let's try that again. Good, so we finally did it. I just looked in the wrong category. It was the right status. Shadow Cloak of Nocturnal, which is a fantastic ability. So if we use it, it costs us magicka. The moment that we start sneaking, we immediately become invisible. There you go. And that works for 30 seconds, reusable, so super strong ability. The other good ability is the full daylight ability, which allows you to immediately absorb 500 health from a target. That would help us to be more sustainable, but I think this in itself is great. Aura Whisper, fine as well. So I think, now that we do have Aura Whisper here, can't be the same ability. Yeah, I need to see how I can hotkey it, but it would be a pretty sizable difference to the playstyle that we had so far. That, however, brings us to the end of today's episode and this run so far. If you want to see more of Carlos de Silva, then please vote for him. I will put up a voting to see who of the characters should go for tier 2, and then continue the playthroughs. Thanks for watching, guys. Sneak to the like button and poke it a little bit whilst you're on your way out, and see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.